Hi, my name is Asher Ferreira, and I have type 1
diabetes.
Some quick context. Currently, there are three mainstream methods for dealing with type 1. Number one, becoming a human pincushion who runs the risk of being mistaken for a drug addict in public before every meal. Number two, adopting a state-of-the-art Tamagotchi with fire alarm quality vocals, except if the numbers on the screen get too low, you die instead. Or, well, riding a blood sugar roller coaster without a seatbelt where each drop could be an express pass to the pearly white gates.
I'm fortunate enough to have access to the second method. Sometimes it feels like life would be easier if I just languish in a pre-programmed existence that allowed me to keep my blood sugar in control all the time. But despite it all, I refuse to lose my determination and spontaneity over the past 9 years. I've lived half my life with this disease, and it ain't gonna slow me down now.
Get everybody in the stuff together. Okay, 3, 2, 1, let's jam.
I may have to drink a lot of Gatorade when I'm climbing in order to keep my blood sugar from crashing. And sometimes, a training session can be ruined by stubborn lows or highs, but nothing, I mean nothing, can stop me from climbing. You gotta love when your pump sight gets ripped off while you're climbing. Didn't stop me though. The thing about climbing is, it involves a lot of falling.
Whoa.
Oh my
god. I took that last fall in an awesome route I'm still working on that illustrates what I love about climbing, the challenge. My favorite climbs are those I can't get on the first try, but have to attempt over and over. Over and over and over and over again until I master the move.
Let's go!
This purple climb felt impossible at first. It's a difficulty level that I've never climbed before, and is also very overhung and laboriously long. But I've puzzled through it so far, only almost injured myself once, and I'm close to completing it today.
If there's one thing climbing has taught me, it's that when something feels impossible in life, it often requires a delicate balance of determination and patience, but also new approaches from different angles.
I may be a chronic diabetic, but I'm also a chronic climber.